bedrooms and to shower.
So we're good?
Mm-hmm. Good luck.
All right. All right, Mike Henry here. I'm gonna do a kind of a quick demo. First I'm gonna start with some color mixing, some color mixing on the palette that I'll be using for this. What kind of caught my eye was the Adirondack chairs, and kind of the theme is shining light on the everyday. And so taking a simple subject, putting a little light on it, make it pop, and we're gonna paint it. So I got my sketch ready. I'm gonna put that away. But first, I'm gonna show you some ways to mix green. And a lot of times, what I'll do is I'll put an orange down first. And as you come down the wheel here, you're going to get a little cooler. And while that's still wet, I like putting some viridian in it. Letting it move around a little bit, and you will get a variety of greens. And as we get down here to the red, we're almost a complement. Darken it up a little bit. I'll go to a staining color, like a phthalo green here. With its complement, rose. And we'll let that move around a little bit too. And then leave some of the underlying color in places. Anyways, that's just a little warm up. And what I like about this cad orange and viridian mix is that when it dries, I can go in there and lift. If I want to lift some highlights, it's real easy to lift it now, but after it dries, I can go in there and lift some nice highlights. The staining colors, not so much, like down here. All right, we're warmed up. So here's my sketch, center point of interest right here, Adirondack chairs. So I'm going to start by just doing a wet wash over the whole foliage along the top. Not being concerned about a couple tree trunks, they're going to be dark, so I can go over that and go on top of my initial wash. So let's get on it. Mix a puddle of this. Some of that. And this is viridian. Like I said, I can lift this. I like to warm it up a little bit, even though I'm putting some color underneath it. And then as I come down here, I'm going to try a little bit of that. And then maybe some of the red too. And I'll keep this kind of wet so that we've got time to work. I don't feel like I got to cover the whole paper. I might leave some white spots because you can always cover them up later. And I've got more light over here. As we're getting into the cooler shadow area, I want some cooler underpainting. Fun to leave some sparkles there, but I probably will paint those out. And I do have to be a little careful around these. I could have masked these. Didn't want to. I will clean up any edges here towards the end. This is just to remind me not to paint these out. So now I don't want this to dry, so we gotta come in here and get some green down. And this is gonna be dark over here, so I'm just gonna keep dumping some paint on that. And if it's looking a little green right now, it's all right. We can always neutralize it later. And it might be kind of fun to leave some of that underpainting show a little bit. Okay, we don't want tangents up here. Fix my corners. I got kind of a half and half thing going on, so I want to carry some of this darker color over. So I'll mix a darker green. Just kind of looking at balance now, I guess. I want strong dark around these guys. I'll finish it up with some little darker green over here. And I want to be careful about the edges up there. Make sure I paint up to it. All right, got some wet spots or some white spots there. That's okay. Some of these we're gonna make them go away just by dampening the paper a little bit. Want to leave some of them though. Spot here. Some of that's going to run down. That's all right. I can lift. Whoa! What happened there? All right, and then while we're here, we're gonna tone the water a little bit too. First of all, let's put some reflection in here. Well, this is all wet. Kind of a bit much here, but just gonna get a light coat on it to cover it up. All right. Now, I'm going to put our dark dock in a little bit. I'm going to make that with like a red orange and a phthalo green. Make kind of a dark brown. And do it while it's still wet, so it kind of runs down the water a little bit. I'll leave a little highlight on there. Just kind of warm it up a little bit over here as it goes off the side and lighten it up so it's not attracting a lot of attention. Like a smooth gradation there. Okay, I'm going to hit this with a hairdryer in just a second. And I gotta pull away from that so I don't blast you. Thing that's going to help us out here, going to help me out, is these white spots. I still want to soften them a little bit because they're just a little too sharp for me. So it's an easy thing to do. Especially in this dark area, but I'll probably, I can glaze over those too. In fact, maybe that's what I'll just leave that. But I got some dark tree trunks in here. I want to put something in there just so I have a little bit of a gauge on, you know, my value. It's going to help me out with my value. I'm going to want to come in with some green here because there's a little too much warm underneath that, but we can do that. Let's start by putting in these tree trunks. So I'm going to mix my green with the red orange. And try that. And let's see. I can, I don't want to do this. I'm going to put these in and then soften them up a little bit. So they're not going to look so stuck on there. So I'm just softening these hard edges because they will attract your eye. I don't really want your eye to go there right away. This could get a little distracting up here too. So while that's still wet, we're gonna put a little mix in there. Also, we'll put a couple more of these guys in over here. That's unplanned, but I think we'll just kind of leave that. See how that's going to work out. All right, I do need some darker value over here. So I'm going to hit this with a mister first. And I'm going to grab some phthalo green. Maybe just a touch of that with its complement here. Rose. We could make a black with that if we wanted to, but we want this to kind of float around, and we're going to save some of that color in there. This is in shadow, but I don't want it to be black. I'm probably going to end up making it black, but around a little bit. Yeah, the idea hopefully is to put it down and stop fiddling with it. But that is easier said than done. still looking like I need a little bit more of a some dark shapes over here because it's too much 50-50. So see if I can't get that a little darker, but not so green. And I'll have to go in and clean out some of those tree trunks. Another thing I can do is put in some almost pure yellow while this is wet. Paint's pretty heavy there. And I can go in here and lift even after this gets dried out a little bit. I can still go in there and lift if it's looking a little too solid. That'd be fun to do some stuff like that. We should put in some water reflections while we're here. Darken this up a little bit. I think I'm going to make the water a little bit lighter than it is. Just because. So it's not just all the same. Here, we'll come in and kind of cut around these guys a little bit. Make that nice and dark. Work on that a little bit more towards the end. soften these edges up a little bit. Might regret that later, but. Okay, I'm gonna hit this with a hairdryer again. Right now. Okay, one thing I like to do when I get going here is to clean the edge of this. I'm going to tape just to sharpen up the image a little bit and see what I got. Get some clean water. Probably noticed my palette's a mess. 15 years ago that used to bug me, but now it doesn't. So I don't know if that's a good thing or not. All right, I'd like the tree trunks to be a little stronger, so I'm going to do something about that first. Lost these guys, so what the? I'll just put a couple more in. Don't want them too strong. just leave this guy alone here. Glaze on these chairs so I have an idea what I'm looking at. So the first wash, it's going to be very pale, and I do want to save some white. It's still wet. Let's drop some darker color underneath here. We'll get this figured out. All right. Okay, we need a little bit of value here. Kind of lightened up on me a little too much. And we need some reflection down here. Okay. I'd still like some stronger value contrast in here a little bit, so we're gonna go with try this one. Quite a compliment, but pretty close. Pretty dark. And I want some of this dark, but not try and get some water lines in here. some of this blend while it's still wet. And kind of grade it down. Hope to make these the right color so I can see what's happening here. A little bit. Darker orange under here in some places. To carry away here, but I probably will. I'm gonna start doing stuff like that. Gonna overwork it. I don't want to do that. So finish up short. Let that go. All right. I gotta stand back and look at this from a distance. Okay. Just a couple things, like a shadow in here, and I'm gonna lift a little bit. I'm gonna lift reflection on a couple of these legs. Still a little wet, so that'll kind of fade in, but maybe I'll put some orange in there while it's wet. Yeah. Just for fun. Okay, and then I'm going to put a little bit of shadow area here. Don't know if it really needs it. It's gonna get it. That's not what I want. So just some break up this hard line a little bit over here. Sure, I carry that off the page. I'm gonna put some orange in there just for fun. Put some over here too. Okay, I talked about lifting earlier, so I'm gonna do it. There's a nice show of light there. Background foliage is kind of understated, maybe too understated, but if I start picking at it, I'll lose my freshness. But I do wanna demonstrate lifting, because I really like doing it. And it's something I do normally towards the end of the painting. I could get carried away, and I have gotten carried away from it. So this area is kind of dark. I can come in here and just with a damp brush lift some shapes. So it'd be like a sky hole or just a light hole. But I don't want to have any kind of a pattern showing here. I want it to be broken up a little bit. let me put one down here. You can see I can almost go back to the white of the paper with some of this, and this is still a little damp. I can vary the shape by brush or just whatever mark I make. And what I like to do is sometimes I'll drop paint in there while it's damp, and then sometimes I'll let it dry and glaze over. You'll get a richer or a pure color if you do that. But let's drop in some brighter color here and see what happens. Doesn't look good. You can always darken it up, paint over it. That's probably a bit too much, but. So, maybe I'll hit that with a spray bottle. Alright, so I could put some, you know, some darker twigs or foliage or sticks back here, but I need to, you know, look at it for a couple days before I start fooling around with stuff like that, because I can overdo it and wreck it. I like what's happening there. I like the reflection. So I'm just going to call this good and keep an eye on it for a couple days. I did do a practice version. And just to show you what I did, so there's a little bit of a difference. If you can see both of that or not, but so this is warmer, lighter, more definition in the trees. Every time you do something like this, you can do something a little different. But I feel on this one, I got the water too dark. It was almost, the value was too close to the background foliage. So with that in mind, I kind of like this idea better, with this darker, this a little bit lighter. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to go with that one. All right. Thanks for watching.